guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is David with Side of Tech, and today we're gonna be talking about my Mac and PC setup for 2021. Now I know what you guys are thinking. David, Mac and PC together? How does that work? Well, in today's video, I'm gonna go ahead and explain that to you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe. That way you guys can keep up with all my future tech videos. And without any further delay, let's get to it. All right, so let's start off with the gaming PC. And my gaming PC is not anything fancy. I just wanna let you guys know that. I'm not running the latest NVIDIA graphics card or anything like that. So for a chipset, I'm running an AMD Ryzen 7 3700X. And for the price of this chip, it's amazing for what it does. For gaming, you really don't need anything else above what I have. It's really nice to have those 8 cores rather than the 4 that you get with the Ryzen 5, but I love this chip. And the motherboard I'm using is an Asus X570E gaming motherboard. When I first built this PC, it was really nice to just have all those ports available on my motherboard, and this motherboard is perfect for all those extra accessories that you guys need to plug into your computer. Now, I'm gonna address the elephant in the room. We can't get graphics cards. It's impossible. So for now, while the endless search is still going on, I'm running a 5700 XT. Right now, I'm currently playing Mass Effect Legendary Edition. It's awesome, it runs perfect for that. And then in a future video, I wanna go over my gaming PC with you guys. I wanna cover all the nooks and crannies with this thing and how I built it. Since I have to switch between Mac and PC all the time, I'd rather use 2 keyboards. So currently I'm using the Kcron K4 for my Mac. And then for my PC, I use the Logitech G915 TKL version. And for the current mice that I'm using, for my productivity Mac setup, I'm using the Logitech MX Master 3. And then for my PC, I like using the Logitech G502 wireless. And I love this thing. This thing is so awesome. The wireless connectivity is perfect. And then for headphones, I like using my Bose QC Quiet Comfort 1s. These things are old. They're beaten up, but they still run great and they still block out a lot of noise. And then I have them just resting on this Just Mobile headphone stand. Now, as far as wireless charging goes, I like using this Nomad base station stand. It's really functional, and then it also has 2 wireless charging coils, so that way you can charge your AirPods on here, you can charge your iPhone, whatever cell phone that uses wireless charging, and it's perfect for that. Now, I've had multiple questions on this next product, which are my Audio Engine speakers. I've had them for going on 4 years now, and these things are still kicking. They still rock a pretty good amount of bass for not having a subwoofer. These things not only perform amazingly, but they look really nice. It goes really nice with my walnut desk. And then for my iPad, I'm just using the 2018 version. I kind of want to upgrade this iPad to the M1 version, but I don't know, it just does everything that I need it to. And I just feel like with the M1 version of the iPad and with having no pro apps, it's just not a good buy right now. Next, I'm gonna go over the BenQ Screen Bar Plus. Now this thing has come in clutch so many times for me during those late night work sessions. It also comes with this nifty knob that you can adjust all of your fine tuning on the light. And as you can see, this thing can get pretty bright. The next piece of gear I have on my desk is the CalDigit TS3 Plus Thunderbolt 3 dock. Now this thing is a game changer. It has all the ports that you'll need on any kind of setup. It has 5 USB-A ports, 2 USB-C ports, and what comes in really clutch is this thing has a UHS 2 SD card reader. And like I said, it has more ports for everything that you might need for your desk setup. Now one of the most important piece of kit on any desk setup is the monitor. The monitor I'm rocking is an LG UL850. It's a 27-inch monitor. The monitor has USB-C, and then it also has a display port. And these are the ports that I use for switching in between my Mac and PC. And whenever I'm done editing or doing any kind of videos or anything like that, and it's time to game, it's so easy to just switch. Now this monitor only runs 60 FPS with a display port. For the games that I like to play, it's not really a big deal. I mainly like playing single player games anyways, so this is perfect. And then now for my Mac. I'm rocking the 2018 Mac Mini. This is the version with the Intel Core i7 chip, and that's the one that has 6 cores and it runs at 3.2 gigahertz. And this thing needs to be replaced. Yeah, this Mac Mini can handle a lot of things, but a lot of things it can't. For one thing, I use the Canon R5, and that thing uses a codec that my Mac Mini just can't handle. It takes me hours to just download all the items into proxy media, and yeah, it's not a good time. I'm really looking forward to the new MacBook Pros that Apple might release this coming June. I hope so. I mean, it's Apple. And lastly, I want to cover my desk. What I have is a fully Jarvis standing desk. It's a fully motorized desk where all you have to do is press a button and then you can customize all of your presets. So when your butt's all tired, you can go ahead and stand up and still work on your next projects. That'll go ahead and cover my 2021 desk setup. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video as it's been years of perfecting and fine-tuning this setup. And as you can tell from all the tech used in this video, you don't really need all the latest and greatest items. All you need to do is find out what works for you and your needs. Now with all that being said, thank you so much for stopping by today's video. And don't forget to like and subscribe, that way you can keep up with all my future tech videos. And again, this is David with Side of Tech. Peace.